Good morning. Today we will see the experimental demonstration of magnetic field along the axis of a circular coil carrying current. So we have here a coil. Coil is given with 140 turns. Suppose if I pass a current through this coil, along the axis of the coil there will be a magnetic field produced. And that field will be maximum at the center, and as the distance increases from that point on both the sides, the field reduces down. This is what we are going to study in this specific experiment. So when a magnetic field is produced, at different points we can measure the field using the Biot-Savart law. The equation for that field strength is B is equal to mu 0 Ni by 2 R squared by X squared plus R squared raised to 3 by 2. This is the equation derived from the Biot-Savart law. Mu 0 is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. This is called as the absolute permeability of free space. N is the number of turns, in this case it is 40. I is the current flowing through the coil, which we will be setting with the help of a DC voltage source. R is the radius of the circular coil, so from the center to the extreme point. To measure that, we can measure the circumference using a thread. We can measure the circumference from 2 pi r value, we can find out the radius. X is the distance of the point where we are measuring the field strength from the center of the coil. This is the equation. So by knowing the current flowing through the coil and the distance, I can easily find out what is the field strength. Now, how to measure this field strength? To measure the field strength, we are using a compass box. In this compass box, you can see here there is a magnet, a dark magnet is there, small piece of magnet, and this magnet will be always aligning along the Earth's field if there is no other field present. Earth is having a magnetic field, its field strength is 3.5 into 10 to the power minus 5 Tesla, we call it as B0. So if there is no other field, that means if I am not passing the current through the coil, there is no field present in this, only Earth's field will be present. So this needle is pivoted, so it will be aligning along that direction. That is called as magnetic meridian. Even if I rotate this compass box little bit, you can see the magnet will be always in the same direction. Perpendicular to that, there is an aluminium pointer fixed. The end readings, you can see here almost both the sides end readings are same. So now, so I'm putting it like this. If this is the direction of the Earth's field B0 and there is no other field present, the magnetic needle will be like this, in this direction needle will be like this, north south. It is in the north south direction. Now if I give a current through the coil, a field will be generated along the axis of the coil, so that I am marking in this direction. This is B0, this is B. So from this position, now when the field was not there, when the coil was not giving the magnetic field, magnetic needle was in this direction. Now due to the presence of the field, that is when you apply a current through this coil, field is produced, the field is acting in this direction, the resultant direction will be like this. Field direction is in this way. So the magnet will turn along the resultant field direction. So the magnet will be coming like this in that direction. That means this is turning through an angle theta. So if this is B, this also is B. So I can write tan theta equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So B I can write as B0 tan theta. This is called as tangent law. So using a compass box at different points, if I measure what is the angle turned by the magnetic needle, even using this equation I can calculate the field strength. Now we are doing the experiment using this tangent law. Now we'll have to pass a current through this coil, so I'll take a voltage source. This voltage source I am connecting to the commutator. This is a commutator which will help us to reverse the direction of the current. So I have connected the voltage source at these two points. Now I have connecting wires from the coil one wire from the coil are connected to the bottom point of the commutator, another one to the emitter, now from the ammeter back to the second terminal of the commutator. This is secure. Now when the commutator is in the off position, there is no current, so this magnetic needle will be along the magnetic meridian. Okay, if I close the commutator, current start flowing through the coil and the magnet will turn towards the resultant field direction. So initially we have to set the coil along the magnetic direction. So for that what we can do is, see here on this dial there are readings marked. I can bring the 90-90 line joining 90 on this side and 90 on this side in the coil plane. So now 90-90 is in the plane of the coil. Now I can slowly rotate this instrument as a whole and bring the reading of the aluminium pointer to 0-0. When the reading comes to 0-0, magnet is actually perpendicular to that, so magnet will be pointing 90-90 is already in the plane of the coil, so magnet is along the plane of the coil, or you can say magnet is in the magnetic meridian. So in this case field is not applied, magnet is along the magnetic meridian. Now if I close this along any one direction, now I'm setting this distance is zero. So when I take the field strength, I'll be getting the field exactly at the center of this coil. So I'm closing the, so a current start flowing. So if I want to use this equation, I can note what is the current in this. So now the, you can see here the magnetic needle turned perpendicular to that, we have the aluminium pointer
Now the aluminium pointer is giving me a reading. So if you look from the top, if you see the image, what we see at the background below mirror is there, and if the image and the needle overlaps, then you'll be getting the correct reading. Now I'm getting about 75 as the reading. So I'll take the reading as 75. So this position x is 0, I'm getting theta 1 and theta 2, 75 degree and 75 degree. Now reverse the commutator. I'm reversing the commutator. When I reverse the commutator, I can see the magnet turns in the other side, and the when it comes to rest, the reading corresponding to that will be very close to this 75 only. We'll see what is the reading. Now the magnet almost it is coming to rest, so it is slightly more, it is giving you nearly 79. Four readings we are getting. If you take the average of this 4 theta, this value we can use in this equation. So for this specific case, when x is equal to 0, I can calculate the field strength at that point as B0, that is 3.5 into 10 to the power minus 5 Tesla multiplied by tan of average of this 4 angles. This will give what is the field strength at the center. Now to study the variation of the field along the axis of the coil, I can move the compass box towards one side, left side. If I move, so slowly I'm moving it to say 2 centimeter. I'm moving it to 2 centimeter. So x is now 2. Now the present position readings I can note. Again, if I reverse the commutator, I'll be getting the other direction 4 readings I'll be getting. I can go for the mean and calculate what is the field strength at 2 centimeters from the center of the coil. This I can repeat for different distances, 4, 6, 8, 10, like so one side for different specific distances. I'm measuring 4 readings each, average I'm calculating, and from the average I'll go for the field strength. Same way, distance can be selected on the other side. So at 2 centimeter, if I see, I'll be getting again 2 readings, reverse the commutator, 2 more readings. So on this I can repeat for distance, same distances on the right side as well. So I'm getting the field strength at the center, field strength towards the left side for specific distances, and field strength for the same distances on the right side. And now if I plot a graph, if I take x-axis like this, y-axis, if along the y-axis if I take the field strength, and along the x-axis if I take the distance, so I can mark 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So for this distance, same distances I can mark on the other side as well. Now the field strength we got maximum at the center, so some point I'll be getting here, and gradually it was decreasing down for different distance, so I'll be getting the graph this same way on the other side also. So this is the variation of the field along the axis of the coil. Suppose if you are asked to find out what is the Earth's magnetic field, then what you have to do is, in the place of B, we'll put this mu 0 ni by 2 into r squared by x squared plus r squared raised to 3 by 2. Then we have, this is equal to B0 tan theta. So B0 can be determined from this equation. This is clearly showing how the magnetic field is varying along the axis of the coil. Okay, thank you.